What's up, everybody? Welcome to my version, TSP Productions, The Steaming Pile, transferring over to Weird News soon. Come on in, say what's up. Everybody, welcome to mine. Sean's going live here in a minute. We're going to bring up the agenda and get started. So, get settled in. Put some snarky comments in the chat room.
Yeah, get them ready.
Go and answer the poll. I think you have 10 more minutes. Who's better, Led Zeppelin or Pink Floyd?
Did you make one on Twitter or something?
Twitter, and I used Share to Steam.
Perfect.
No one on Steam replied, of course. But I got some votes. But I got some votes. And I got some people took it on Twitter.
Good idea. Yeah, if we can come up with like a debate every time.
Oh, Harfat commented here. I'll save it for the discussion.
All right, I'm going here. Boom. All right, we're going to switch. And then I got X-Files playing in the background. Gotta hit the X-Files. Welcome to Weird News, everybody. I'm gonna bring up the agenda, like John said.
Oh, I thought I was gonna hear the X-Files theme song too.
I don't know how I can just set it up so that
you got it on your sound in your OBS.
Can I share computer sound?
No.
Share. No. Oh, but then now you can't see me. Let's see here.
Well, you're off to the side.
Oh, that doesn't work. It doesn't show on my OBS.
Right.
So no, we'll figure that out later.
It won't.
Any hoozle. So, like I said. So what is the, I need, the code is the same as last time.
Yep, 599-401-010. You need it again?
Yeah, 599.
Yep, 401.
401.
010. 010. Go to zoom.us, hit that code, everybody. It's on the top of mine. And come on in. We are live on my YouTube, John Spaulding, and my Vim TV account. And Sean, where we live at for you? Official D Live. Anywhere else?
Yep. Nope. That's it.
You turned off your caster? They gave us 7 days grace period.
Ah, fuck them.
You want to be a capitalist? No, I had it. You want to be a capitalist organization? Fuck you.
I had already stopped because the lag was like really long between comments. And so it was hard to interact with people when I was just streaming through. I mean, I was multi-streaming, but those are the only people I was talking to. So it's like, okay, why am I just
where
streaming there on DLive?
Oh, on DLive, on DLive. It was it took longer using Caster.
Yeah,
with the delay.
Yeah, it was weird. It seems to be quicker now. So for some reason, whatever, wherever it's got to go to do its thing, it seemed to have like a longer lag. Now it could have just been a coincidence and something that, I mean, you know, but I seem to see a difference.
Right.
So, yeah. All right. So I was just grabbing the meeting number. Now, will it be this meeting number from now on, John, or will this be changing up?
No, I believe so. I believe so.
That it will be the meeting number.
This will be the meeting number from now on. Yep.
Okay. Okay. That's cool. So I'm going to keep this in my OBS. Okay. Oh, here we go. So the if you're just showing up to my stream, the Zoom link is in chat, or you can just hang out for a minute in the chat if you don't want to join, and we'll be starting soon. I'm just hopping into my overlays tab or scene to drop the Zoom number for y'all on screen. Where shall it go? Definitely doesn't need to be so gigantic. We'll put it right there in the middle. Boom. There it is. Join up. Come say hi.
You have an overlays tab?
Yeah. So that way, everything that's on it is so you can add scenes to your scenes, right?
Mm-hmm.
And so I've got one scene that's all GIFs. And then I've got one scene that's all Tidy Labs overlays, and then one scene that's all the weird news thing. And what I do is after each story, I scroll up, I pop into the weird news scene and scroll it up. And whatever, no matter what scene everyone else sees, no matter what scene I'm on, I know that my three main scenes have that scene in them.
Mm-hmm.
And so it will move on all of them. And so it's kind of how I control it.
Cool. I like it.
Yeah, I will be able to do it more, a little more streamlined with my Stream Deck here.
Mm-hmm.
But for now, that's how I got it. It's going to take a little more time to get that together. But I think I'd be able to just to hit buttons and have it go and move up itself, maybe.
Okay.
Just by, but I'll have to have like a shitload of scenes. So I'm not sure how that'll run on, if that'll affect how my computer runs or anything like that.
Right, right.
Yeah.
It will.
Could be fine. Could really fuck everything up, so. All right, boom. Let's begin.
Let's do it.
Gonna flip this over here. Well, I guess. Weird news number 6. Okay, well, I said it was 7 on DLive, but.
Thank you, Tretch Renfro.
All right, so here's our rundown, more or less. First, we're going to start with, you know, just some fun science health news, making sure everyone stays healthy.
You're not screen sharing, you're just sharing it?
I will, yeah.
I'll screen share. If you could.
Yeah. Just going to close some stuff. Do you need the Zoom tab open? No, you don't. That's right. Close. You need that open. Close that. Close that. Close that. Okay. Oh, thank you for whoever just dropped some coin. Dude, hello. How are you? Dropping the lemons early. I appreciate it. We're going to share our screen here. Share screen two. Boom. All right. I don't like that. That just sits there. All right. So here we got, man, bring in the lemons. I appreciate it. First one is, there used to be like the old wives' tale to eat human placenta. Well, I mean, even though that's fucking gross and only hippies are doing it, it's bad for you too. So, ha, hippies. Strike for the meat eaters, or a win for the meat eaters. Canadian gynecologists, so actually maybe you want to take it with a grain of salt. I don't know, depending on how you feel about Canada. I'd actually maybe even trust them more than American doctors. I wonder if they have, do the pharmaceutical companies have such a fucking handle and foot grip hold on the government? I wonder. I don't hear about it.
So. They do.
They do? Okay. All right.
Oh, in Canada? I don't know.
Yeah, in Canada. Like, I thought is a little harder. I don't know. Who knows? Maybe he got bought out, just like the rest. I didn't read up on this one too much. Something about it, like, can cause, there's no strong evidence, first of all, but that doesn't ever stop anybody, right?
Nope.
Evidence. If enough people said it worked in their family, then if, my dad's any indication, they'll be like, nah, fuck it. Don't care what the book said.
A group of hepatitis. All right. Let's slow down.
Yeah. Okay.
A group of Chicago gynecologists is urging people not to eat the human placenta.
Sure.
A recommendation from the Study of Obstetricians and Gynecologists of Canada published indicates there's no evidence of a health benefit from the practice of placentophagy. There is a potential for serious harm. The placenta is a temporary organ that provides oxygen. Here's the thing. I don't think anyone does this because they think it has a health benefit. They might get swooned in to believe that, but I think they do it for some more spiritualistic, ritualistic type thing.
Interesting.
That's what I think. I don't think they do it because they think it's like, I don't know. Maybe they do if like the woman's breastfeeding. They think that, I don't know. It's weird. It's a little cannibalistic to me. But, I don't think that's why they do it. But I would be concerned about the potential for serious harm.
How is it just a little cannibalistic? Holy shit. How did I not miss this detail of the... that's exactly what it is, right? Whether you're fucking cooking it or using it in this weird fucking thing. Let's watch. Let's see what the fuck this is about.
Oh, God.
There's a whole diversity.
Oh, come on. We're not giving them any.
Fuck off, oldie. We're not listening to your science.
Get out of here with your botanical garden. Oh, here we go.
Are advising people not to eat human placenta. You heard me right. Now, some people might be wondering why is that warning needed in the first place, but it has become a growing trend raved about by some celebrity moms, for example, Kim Kardashian.
They get it in pills? They turn it in a pill?
Depression, breast milk production, iron levels. The medical community, though, pushing back, saying no, there is no strong evidence.
There you go. FDA is like,
and in fact, there's even a risk of contamination.
Yeah, but
it comes consuming raw placenta or cooked or in a pill form could lead to viral or bacterial infections. Alicia, let me start with you. And whether you think folks are doing their research on stuff like this, are they blindly following these celebrity health trends? What do you think?
Well, I think they are kind of blindly following these celebrity health trends.
Shit. I don't even listen
you
to
mentioned this type
that.
Of thing. And I think that for their openness about postpartum depression and.
Yeah. Okay. I think I get the gist.
Aurora Cannabis is down 45 cents when that was airing.
Yeah. I don't really care what this girl has to say.
Eh.
Okay, that was a bad show.
So you're not in favor of eating placenta?
Well, I mean. Like they said, there was never any
health. Here's the only thing I remember about my wife's, our first child is, I was holding the baby. She had, our firstborn was delivered cesarean. And there was a teacher in there and some students and then everybody else. So there was like a shitload of people in this room. And I'm holding the baby and I hear this clang. Come on, everyone. Come on over here. And all the students went around this little metal table. They were all standing around and the nurse is poking this thing and slapping it and looking at it. She goes, now this is a healthy placenta.
Bam. All right.
So that's all I got, man. That's all I got is like, you know, I looked over and it looked like a 64 ounce steak. It was like real thick.
In a good way? Like you were like, damn, I could grill that shit up, son.
Well, I mean, I don't have those kind of urges or tendencies, so I did not have that thought. But that's what it kind of looked like.
Interesting.
Yeah. Anywho.
For everyone watching,
you guys don't have any. You guys don't have any placenta pills at your house? Ooh.
No.
I love Manhattans with bullet rye.
Oh, baby. I hadn't tried them with rye yet, at all, for the longest time. I was using, some would consider the wrong whiskeys.
There's no such thing as the wrong whiskey. It's an acquired taste. I'm sorry, it's not an acquired taste. It's whatever you appreciate.
Exactly. Yeah. So I mix it with some of this.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, yeah, you can see it. Cherry bomb.
Now, what is the cherry bomb? Is it just a cherry liquor?
It's whiskey from Oregon that has natural cherry flavor.
So you mix whiskey with whiskey?
Well, it's a little cherry whiskey with the rye and then some sweet vermouth.
Okay.
And I put a couple of dark cherries in it, you know.
Oh, my goodness. I'm jealous right now.
Yeah. And so I'm throwing those. Boom. Into the shaker. And we're good to go. So that's concerned.
I don't have any cherries, so I just put a couple dabs of bitters in there.
Oh, yeah. I did do bitters, too. We've got some Boulevard bitters up in this piece today. Yeah. It's chamomile, jasmine, cinnamon, and raisins.
Go away. That sounds like something.
It's pretentious. That's
it
pretentious.
Sounds like it's a West Coast bitters.
It is. It's a little bougie, but, fuck it.
Whatever.
Fuck it. All right, so the next one, let's see here, is going to be, oh, okay, we know what the next one's going to be. Let's see how easy of a transition we can make it, though. Studio. See, this is in the way. Okay. Whoop. Next up. Floyd versus Zeppelin.
All right.
Now, in the future, maybe this would be smarter to do towards the end and like use it as a bookend. But for now, I couldn't help it. I threw it right up at the top. So now I need to go to it.
And while you're bringing it up, I'll read in a comment from Harvat. Mm-hmm. On my post, he says, and I think this is a good way to kick off the discussion. He says, ugh. Right? Terrible start. He said, well, which is better would depend on what you were or are doing when listening to them. For me, it'd be Pink Floyd most of the time. So that's Harvat. Okay. Now, let's go for the Twitter poll. Had some action. Not a whole lot, but it had some. And the final results are in. Are you ready?
I'm super ready.
Six people voted. I did not.
I didn't either.
50-50. Pink Floyd, Led Zeppelin, 50-50.
Wow, of course. Well, that does us no good.
No, it does no good because we're going to argue.
Yeah, I mean, we still...
But then, you know, I kind of agree with Harvat with his first part, except then my default would be, like how he said, depends on what you're doing at the time for which one's better or are doing.
Sure.
And his default would be Pink Floyd, my default would just be Led Zeppelin. I think they're both good. And so I was going to ask you is, I wanted to hear your opinion, because I saw you post it, and I was like, false, wrong. But I think it's just a matter of preference. Mine is not for, I think what, mine just isn't for what Pink Floyd brings to the table. I, like, want more, I don't know, kind of rock,
okay.
Slower, but I don't know. Just the music is a little, the music's faster. Pink Floyd's a little bit slower to me, and sometimes I can fall asleep listening to them.
I love that that explanation, actually, because, you know, I'm a hard rock, I'm a metal guy, so I get that. It's definitely, and that's the easiest thing to say, I suppose, is that it depends on your mood, because of course they're different enough that you can say that. I guess it comes down to, when I first think of it, I think, okay, well, Pink Floyd has better lyrics, right? Led Zeppelin's, overall, Led Zeppelin's thinking about, you know, fucking Lord of the Rings and fairies and shit.
Mm-hmm.
And Pink Floyd's got these, like, deep, you can, like, be philosophical with it, like war and fucking The Wall, the movie. I mean, they're just, you know, multimedia band. And also, when I brought this up to Tony,
You don't think Led Zeppelin's a multimedia band? You mean because they didn't do a movie integrated with one disc?
Yeah, I guess that's it. Yeah, right there. They got them. Hey, what did
the Led Zeppelin has a movie?
Do they?
Yeah, I think they got a movie.
Exactly.
We're going to find out. Know. I think they do. But you can keep talking about your conversation. I will be listening in the background.
Okay. Let me see. Let me close this down. So Tony was saying that.
The song remains the same.
Well, okay. Pink Floyd, all original. All original music. Led Zeppelin, they might have stolen some music.
And the Beastie Boys stole music from them. So they got they got their just desserts.
God damn it. That's sampling. That's different.
Oh, shit. So this is the first I've heard of the Led Zeppelin stealing of music. But I won't say that I don't believe you, because I think you've forgotten more about music than I'll ever know.
Well, I had forgotten about that until Tony had brought it up, right? And then it reminded me that when I was delivering pizzas a few years back, I worked with the guitar player for Paul Revere and the Raiders, right?
Okay.
And he would, like, be gone for weeks at a time. Then he'd come back, and he was like, oh, yeah, I was on a cruise, you know, made a few $1,000, and this is just what I do to hold down the fort sort of thing. And he was like, he's the one that first told me about it. I don't think I had actually heard about it before then. But, yeah, I remember he was talking about him and his other guy were, like, going deep about how they knew one of the original drummer for Led Zeppelin before it was Led Zeppelin, and, like, all the drama. Like, it was such a long fucking story. But it ended up being, like, about how they were ripping off these different bands that, like, were coming up around them or something like that. So from what I understand. Yeah. If freaking Tony was here, he'd back up his story.
Yeah, I guess for right now, we're just going to have to leave the poll at 50-50.
Yeah, I guess so.
I'm looking for comments. You got any comments on yours? I don't have any on mine.
Nothing. I'm getting nothing over here.
No.
No. It's broken. That's what's happening.
Weird news is broken.
Weird news is broken. That's okay. All right, so we'll move on for now anyways. We can always have, if leave a comment, jump in if you think differently. I think Pink Floyd, you know, I think I won. I think I won it for Pink.
No.
You have nothing. You have no defense for them stealing music, sir.
The defense rests. I don't have to. They're way better.
Talking about Mordor.
All you have to do is Mordor.
Mordor.
Mortar is what you put in between bricks.
No, I know
bricks.
What it is, John. Fuck off. I get it. Okay, moving on. All right. So, boom, boom, boom.
I need to get a seamless transition tab to.
Almost.
wait so until the screen share.
All right, so next is Glass House. This one's interesting, and I'm just going to let you read the headline, and you tell me what you your first thoughts are.
All right, let's see it.
On all TV, and we're sharing.
What's up, dude, on the web? Welcome, and howdy back. Come on in. Say hello. High Court will decide if Indigenous people without citizenship can be deported in Australia.
Okay. Right. Seems silly. Okay. And my first interaction with this was Americans talking shit about how stupid the Constitution is or how stupid their government is. And I'm just like, well, come on.
My first thought of this is, how is 45 going to turn this into a way to get rid of Native Americans?
Well, yes, that is the natural, you know, thought progression. Is,
oh, right? Shit. Like, if this goes through.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
They're going to be like, you know, Alec and all those other law writing things will be seeing it shortly.
They're going to say, hey, look, you know, obviously we've got to make sure to count everyone, right? So we're going to just make sure we put them all in one place so we know where they all are at one time, right? We're just counting them. Then we're going to let them go. We're just going to make sure they're all here, right, and accounted for. No one holding out.
So what's this one? What am I missing?
Nothing. It's just fucking retarded. I don't know. I didn't even read it more than that. I'm going to be honest. I just thought, how dare they fucking even just leave them the fuck alone? What's the problem?
We need clarification by the highest court in the land to say someone who is Aboriginal, who is descended from the first people of Australia before the European settlement, can't be an alien.
Yeah. In an submission filed with the High Court last month, lawyers for the men argued that they could not be considered aliens under the Australian Constitution. Quote, we need that clarification by the highest court in the land to say that someone who is Aboriginal, who is descended from the first people of Australia before the European settlement, can't be an alien, said Senior Associate Claire Gibbs.
They need clarification to say that? It seems pretty clear to me.
Yeah, if it's under, I mean, this guy, they're arguing that it can't be considered aliens under the Australian Constitution. And then this person's saying, well, we need some clarification. So I wonder what the actual verbiage is.
Right.
It must be, you know, shady. And how long ago was this, like, in comparison to, because people would say, well.
It says immigration laws changed in 2014, allowing visas to be revoked if a person's been convicted of a crime carrying a jail sentence. Data shows the number of cancellations has increased. A portion of people currently detained at offshore detention centers face the prospect. Oh,
right. I mean, it's not a good start. That's for sure.
Doesn't look good. If it starts and works over there, they'll find a way to have it start and work over here.
I suppose that's true. They'll definitely look into it. Let's say, boom. King Floyd, Led Zeppelin.
Oh, we had that discussion already.
I know, but
where was that graphic when you needed it?
It was up.
Oh, it was up on yours.
I forgot to share it with you.
I see what's going on over here.
I forgot that part. I didn't think about that. Everything else has got a link, and I didn't have a link for this, and so I just threw it up. I made it real quick.
Where is that? So where is this playing right now that I'm able to see it? Is it just on your browser? Or?
Oh, I have it as my background.
Oh, okay.
So I, if you look here, I got a TV as my second screen.
Oh.
And so, yeah, I just switched between those. I have it as an extension screen.
Dude on the web, I think the article stated that they would send them to New Zealand.
Yep. Right? Like, New Zealanders are like, what the fuck?
I don't know. I think I'd rather be in New Zealand. Have you seen those clickbait articles for the number of weird and wicked, like, animals that are indigenous to Australia?
That's true.
Send me to New Zealand, man.
What's where... the equivalent for us? Like, sending the Native Americans to Mexico?
For us?
Is that what it would be?
Yeah, I mean anywhere. No, Canada. Canada.
Canada? Yeah, Canada will take them.
That's what it would be like.
Canada.
Yeah.
Canada will be like, yeah, fuck you, America. That's fine.
Yeah, we'll take
them. Come on. We're sorry. We're sorry. Oh, very sorry about that.
Hey.
Hey. All right. Enough making fun of poor Canadians. They get it enough, right? I doubt that, though. Okay. Let's see. Now, the one thing that's a pain in the
ass. Well, they don't like eating the placenta, so they're on your side, or you're on their side.
There you go. If I could, it's true. If I could do the share screen and connect it to my Stream Deck so I could just push that and a push of a button, share the screen in Zoom, that would be awesome. So Zoom, get on it. Connect with Stream Deck.
Come on, Zoom.
Program that shit.
I don't even think we're using Zoom the way they intended it.
That's true. Well, there was another one, appear.in. That people were using, which was kind of cool. They were like in there grabbing each camera and moving it where they wanted on the screen.
I like that. I like that.
Yeah, he's got like massive amounts of people. It's a new chatting streamer on DLive.
That's cool.
I really like his setup.
Yeah, so it's cool. When we were doing 2016 TV, John used to be able to do that with his. He would be able to get everybody in the Hangout individually and then put them wherever he wanted on the screen. And with Zoom, you just can't do that. I mean, if anyone comes in, it messes up your scene. You can't do like a window share or anything like that because it just...
Right.
Yeah. New law allows students to use medical marijuana at Washington public schools.
Yeah. It's legal, baby.
So, but how old are these kids?
Anyone that's got a legal, a card, you know,
is what's the legal age though? Isn't there like, isn't it 18 or
no, not for medical, for recreational. Yes. But growing up, I knew people that were sick that had medical.
Oh, right. Well, I guess if you have really young. Yeah. Okay. I see what you're saying. And so they would just go like any other kid down to the nurse and take their treatment or what?
And take a pill. We're talking about pills again.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, well, that's cool. Yeah. Good for them. Maybe it'll help them focus, too, for some rote education.
Yeah, it's really short. It's known as Ducky's Law, named after a 9-year-old River Ducky Barclay who suffered from a rare and severe genetic disorder. And I'm assuming that it's helping them a lot to take it. And so they're able to probably go to public school, which is a lot cheaper for the parents and so on and so forth. So, because they were having to go away from school and use it. Governor Jay Inslee said, so anyway, there you go.
Okay. Boom. That's cool. I like that.
Yeah.
That's not weird, but no. Other people would.
That's the whole idea, right? I guess, you know, a lot of it's just, we're normalizing it a lot in this state, and I assume that's happening in states that it's been legal.
Did you see Denver is putting magic mushrooms on the ballot?
Oh, if you're watching, you see it's down there. 1, 2, 3, 4. It's a few stories down there. We'll be getting to it.
Yeah. Oh, then I'll
see. This is just sad. I don't want to watch like sick kids. Yeah, I get it.
We agree.
Stopping kids from
Right. We agree. Let them. Give it to kids with ADD, too.
Exactly.
If they're doctor and parents.
Well, I mean, yeah, that's a slippery.
Yes. Right? I said it, and then I'm like, wait a minute.
if correctly prescribed.
Hold up. Yeah. Hold up 1 second.
Yeah, and even then, who knows? All right. So next, Denny's Smoke. All right. We're going to go.
I like where this is headed.
Yeah, well, when you go to Denny's, you got to be ready for this sort of thing.
This isn't a fight, is it? Is this another fight video?
Gosh, I wish this had a video. I don't think it does. We'll see. If it does, we're playing it. This guy went to do a report. A reporter went there and was attacked by he was kicked out. Oh, it's a video. I wonder. Okay, we're going to see something, hopefully.
This is already awesome.
Okay, I'm glad I kept it muted.
We'll skip here.
That's true, Harvat. Every kid has ADD, so that would be difficult.
That's all they're going to be. That's all it is. Just sit the still in.
Employees at Denny's in Lithonia. At Denny's.
Oh, in Lithonia. Where the fuck is Lithonia? There's the poor chat. Adam Murphy. Okay, that's the cameraman.
Oh, that poor guy.
There she is. Ah! That's what she sounded like.
I love this music.
It's a weird aww video that they put together.
Right.
It's weird. Okay. Whatever. Definitely like the opposite of what I was.
They're like, you gotta add video to your post to make it more engaging.
Yeah, they read that.
They read that. Definitely.
Well, that's a good story.
I suppose.
He went in to go. Could you imagine, like, though, being that low on the totem pole at your news organization that you have to do and cover the restaurant report cards?
Oh,
like going in and going checking places after they've gotten those violations. You know, because all those are public record. Everyone sees them. The owners get embarrassed. Da 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 da. Then you got to be the reporter tagging along in there with your camera. And a lot of those are private places, so they don't have to allow you to go in there.
Exactly. So, herpes be fucking, and I'm not talking about the Kardashians and Kanye. I'm talking about actual herpes of different sorts are having sex and combining powers. But I'm married, so I don't have to worry about this shit. Good luck, man. Singles. I don't think this is why, but this is the sort of thing that they're making porn in California wear condoms, right? What is this world coming to? Taking away our freedoms!
I have met someone in college who wasn't aware that you could also get an oral infection from someone that had an STD.
I don't know.
So chose that as the method?
Someone skipped health class, huh?
That's what you're telling me. So he chose that as the method?
Yikes.
Yeah. It was a fun, fun couple weeks.
Yeah. So two different simplex viruses have mixed their genetic material together or recombined. Basically, that there was more considerably more recombination than had been appreciated before. So just it was more. And this is from the UW. So this is a reoccurring Seattle area.
So they recombine. And what's worrisome about it?
All right. Although scientists knew that the two viruses had mixed in the past, the new study shows that mixing continues to this day.
Herpes viruses as a result, are still having sex.
Yeah, and as a result, the genetic herpes virus continues to evolve, negative implications for the health. For example, it might evolve in a way that would make it resistant to current antiviral drugs. The ability of it to mix with HSV-1, the other type, could also be a barrier to the development of a vaccine against herpes, which doesn't exist.
I gotcha. So we can't have these herpes genes fucking all the time.
I know,
because it could be bad for the entire population. The global population.
Yeah. And music. Wait, no, that's right. We're not talking about that. Okay.
Could be bad. Okay. Music fans, all you festy folks and people that have STDs.
Yeah, that was one we skipped. That Coachella. I see so many stories. So Coachella reported the CDC. Around Coachella reported a whole bunch of outbreaks of sexual disease. And then also saw, I think it's Tinder or one of the dating apps has a special thing where you can hook up at concerts by if you're on the app, you can say, oh, I'm going to this concert in a month. And you can, before the concert, start picking people you're going to bang at the concert. And I'm like, God damn it, if I was only single.
Can you verify?
Not that I have trouble, but.
Can you verify in app that the other person is disease free?
Well, see, that's where our stories combine, John. I guess that's just one man's guess. One woman's prediction.
No. It would have to be like you would have to scan your QR code of your successful test.
That's not a bad idea.
Thank you. Thank you. I got a couple.
Yeah. Want to not have to take. Yeah. I don't know. It's there. There's something there. People, you'd have to foot the test, though. People wouldn't pay for it. They'll just roll the dice.
Yeah, no,
I'll take the looks test.
But
I'll
you know how test. Well, you know how Twitter does the verified sign next to the name. That's all. You would just have the little, you know, clean icon, and you'd be verified.
You don't have to bring it. I like what you're saying. You don't have to bring it, but you can go to the doctor. You can get it, and somehow they need to officially. Okay, so if only the medical community can combine forces with Tinder, and we can get this kicking.
Right. Just, you know, medical communities longing to be able to put more information out in public records.
It's true.
It's not true.
All right, well, that leads us to...
Oh, we lost a viewer. Come back!
Oh, maybe they're... Oh, man. Who knows?
If you're here and you're not saying anything in the comments on Vim, on my side, say hello.
Is that where they were at, Vim? Yeah. Or... Okay.
On mine. Well, where are yours?
Nowhere.
No D-Livers?
All alone.
Come on, D-Live.
That's okay. I don't have my viewer count on, so they could be lurking.
Oh, they could be there.
I have no active viewers.
What does that mean?
I don't know. Oh. Active in my chat, John. That's what I meant. Okay, we're moving on. This is awkward now. This wasn't supposed to get so awkward. Where are we going?
It's weird news. It's not supposed to get awkward.
Of course it's supposed to get awkward. That's the whole point.
Look at the G2A kid was bored. That was the anyway. Bubonic plague outbreak. There's definitely a theme here. We got the placenta causing stuff. We got STDs, the bubonic plague. I mean, this is some sinister stuff mixed in with some music.
Totally on purpose. Or on purpose? Rather. Yeah.
Bubonic plague outbreak. Passengers quarantined after a couple die from the disease. Oh, from right. hunting so and eating contaminated marmot in Mongolia.
Marmot? Yeah, exactly. What's a marmot?
I don't know.
Question. Let's look it up. A marmot. I've definitely heard the word. There might be two M's in the middle somewhere.
Let's see if our viewers can get it.
Outdoor clothing.
What? No, it's not. I mean, it is.
Yeah, it just said it was. With
it is. That's what they eat.
It's a giant little.
Oh, hi, little guy.
Beaver looking thing. Come on.
Aw, he looks cute. He looks edible.
I mean, he's got a lot of. He's plump. Yeah. Stick him on a stick for
he
sure.
He looks like the little gopher from Caddyshack.
I think that one's just eating a lot. I mean, some of them, they're not all that. Look at that one's.
Look at the one with the vest.
That's a cartoon, John. It's a Super Bowl ad.
That's one good looking marmot.
Oh, boy.
Oh, that anyways, one's, yaw- that
so
one's
apparently
yawning.
These little fucks. Carry the bubonic pigs. Bubonic plague.
Okay, stop plague. Eating marmot, people.
That's odd. Let's see where it says it's from. Did they say?
Harvat said it's not really an outbreak. And then he said marmot's a rodent.
Yeah, that's true. Outbreak is a little fear-mongering there by Mirror. But
so it's just Mongolia. So is it just two
Mongolian
people?
Marmot. Yep, married couple. Have died, leaving their four children orphaned after an outbreak of the plague. 38.
It's spread by fleas living on wild rodents.
Yep. A marmot is a large species of squirrel in Mongolia. There they are. Oh, that's fun. Getting the hazmat suit people on board. Dramatic pictures showed urgent checks by emergency staff and protective clothing on plane passengers.
So no one else died?
Nope, no one else ate the marmot, John. You got to be exposed to that shit. That's not like airborne.
The bubonic plague is not airborne. Okay.
I don't know, right? I think they, people were. It was spreading because of bad. It's not. People shitting.
Aw, look at that. Yeah. They showed you a picture of the marmot.
Yeah.
Aw, hi guy.
They're like, there he is.
I want to get a marmot now.
Death becomes him.
Yeah, I definitely don't want it. I don't want a flea-bitten marmot, but I just.
That says bad shit. That's what that says. Don't come in here. Yeah. All right, so there you go. That's still a thing. Don't really think about animals. They must carry it constantly, though. So, you know? That's one thing you don't, like the post-apocalyptic movies and shit, you never, you always, everyone's like starving and eating animals. Well, someone's going to get the plague.
Harfett says Mongolia. He says, well, two is not an outbreak, which we agree it's not. And he says, and they have marmots have had this disease since the beginning. The beginning of what, Harfett? Time?
Since plague or marmots?
Since the beginning of marmots or the beginning of plague or the beginning of time? Which one? And then he says, very rare to go person to person, the flea bite or contact with dead flesh of a diseased animal or something.
Yeah, so they would have had to get like necro-funky up in that plane. You know what I'm saying? Talking about fucking dead bodies, John.
Sorry. Scares me. Scares me when you say shit like that, like just off the cuff.
Well,
you don't have to hide your camera. You don't have to be bashful.
Did I? What happened?
I don't know. Your camera just went off.
I know. It just we're fine. No, I'm excited. I just got a little excited. That's all. I don't know what happened. I'm still on over here.
You are?
Yeah.
Well, you're a non-video participant in Zoom. You might be on your OBS.
Yeah. Okay. Well, we'll figure it out. Oh, there we go.
Oh, there you are.
Okay. So, yeah. Plague plane.
He said since the beginning of the plague. About 1,600 years ago.
So marmots were... Okay.
Yep.
Fucking marmots. Next. Magic mushrooms is on bat, like we said.
First, we're going to start.
It's on the ballot. First thing we're going to check out, though, is something from the Guardian. Talking about, is microdosing mushrooms going mainstream? And this lady says, it was as if a whole new world opened to me. You can tell this chick is doing a lot of mushrooms just by looking at her. Actually, I mean, that's my fucking. I don't book by a cover, but
let me just lay down on this place, or it's not a placemat, but on this tablecloth.
She does ASMR, you know. I'm sure.
She looks high on mushrooms right there. Look at those pupils.
This is what we're saying, John. Yes, she's saying she's constantly high. She says, I take a very small dose every 3 or 4 days. She weighs out 0.12 grams and just swallows it like any other food. And it removes her anxiety, she says. I am down to try. But where is she getting it? That's what I'm saying. I try. There's no, it's not like people are walking around with mushrooms like they did weed back in the day.
Yeah.
It's not the same. It's just harder to get. More dangerous because people are just faking what they're doing, you know?
No. More dangerous. And
microdosing's been happening for a long time. People have been, you know, messing around with it for a while. And it has had bad and good, you know, anecdotes that go with it, just like everything, I guess.
Mm-hmm.
Tech workers in Silicon Valley claimed tiny amounts of magic mushrooms made them more productive. And this is a pretty long freaking article. Quote, I'll take some on Thursday because I'm upskilling one of my managers and it helps with my interaction and empathy, one person said in this.
All right.
Yeah. So, you know, I don't know. But that leads me to the next story, which is one that John alluded to. And that is Denver taking the long shot. Oh, come on. Watch out. There we go. Of decriminalizing psilocybin mushrooms. So, I mean, this is obviously a long shot, but putting it, I mean, there's always a first shot, right?
Mm-hmm.
There was a time when someone tried with weed and they were like, wow, okay, well, that's never going to go anywhere. So Finally.
What are they voting on in Denver already? Like, why is there already a ballot?
Yeah. Oh, you're saying already in terms of what timeline, John?
Do we? I don't.
You mean of this year's ballot? You mean?
Yeah, okay. I don't have anything. We don't have anything to vote on until.
Yeah. No shit. I didn't even think about that.
What are they? Yeah, it's weird.
They've approved. Okay. When? What? This is from May 6th.
Tuesday.
They've approved Initiative 301, which is on Tuesday's ballot in Denver. Would not make 7th. They've raised.
But would decriminalize it. Okay. So it's not for making it legal. It's for decriminalizing.
Well, that's the first part. Well, yeah, I mean, I guess with marijuana, it was. It was medical first, wasn't it? I mean, that's the way, that was the evolution.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So it's kind of surprising that's the way they're that's not the way they're doing it and going for it, because there's lots of, you know, medical studies that would show the benefits, right? You would think that that would be an easier way to get it, you know, introduced, some legality introduced to it, but I don't know. Maybe they'll pass it and it'll be, again, that floodgate opening, other states get the idea and run with it and maybe do it better or whatever. So we'll see. I don't know how it went. That was, let's see. I wonder if we could find out.
It's lagging early. That was from an hour ago.
Okay.
So, and it's all, where I am is 2 hours ahead. So they're not going to know anything probably until, well, it's 8:30 there now, so they should know by now.
All right, well, next we've got
interesting
misdelivered drugs. This guy goofed. He might not be alive anymore. I don't know, because I mean, this is a pretty big fuck up. It seems. This is another Australia story.
What the hell's going on over there?
Well. Move up the. We're on misdelivered drugs.
Who do you think might not be alive? The people who received it?
No, this dumb fuck who dropped off millions of dollars of drugs to the wrong person. Let's check it out.
Oh, the guy. So the guy who. Yeah, right. I got you.
Yeah. I mean, maybe if that lady didn't know, that'd be a real movie situation. Like the elderly couple doesn't know and they go on a trip with
it.
Did
the couple turn it in to the authorities? Or are we about to find out?
Zeeling Ma operates an online courier business called Pick Me Up, but he's been picked up by police, accused of sending 20 kilos of meth to an elderly couple in the Werribee area.
$10 million worth of drugs being sent to the wrong address to an elderly couple. That's quite incredible to comprehend that someone could be that, I guess, sloppy.
The surprise package arrived at their home around 1 p.m. yesterday. They signed for it, but weren't prepared for what was inside and called police.
They deemed it suspicious as they hadn't ordered anything. Had a look inside, observed a white substance in bags.
Wyndham CIU detectives later executed a search warrant at an address in Bundoora, where the 30-year-old was arrested. Police allege another 20 kilograms of ice was found at the Maroondah Terrace share house. The total haul an estimated street value of around $20 million.
That's 800,000 hits off the street that we've intercepted yesterday, which is, in terms, that's quite significant.
And, that's huge amount.
Z-Link, also known as Matthew, was at badminton training last night when police.
Oh, that is not a baller
way.
Oh,
boy.
At all.
And the court picture.
Border control drug. The court heard English is his second language and it's his first time in custody. He was remanded to reappear in July. Detectives also raided a number of properties across Melbourne's western suburbs, including this home in Williams Landing. Close to 100 plants were seized. Oh, in the separate operation, a 29-year-old man was arrested and charged.
Wow.
We've been able to get him off the street, and it's a win for the police and for the community.
Miri Tai, Nine News.
In Australia? Guess not.
That's fucking news to me.
They're hardcore over there.
Not good enough for guns. Too good for weed, huh? I don't know. I don't get you.
Harfat says it seems like a setup. I don't think so. What kind of setup?
Yeah, I'm interested.
That seems
what
like
you
that, yeah. That you say more. That seems like an idiot. I want to know how he got his money though, to get that much, and then he's got all those properties. He's got all those properties. Well, maybe he is a fall guy, but so that's where that could be where the stuff originated from. Didn't necessarily mean that he was the one that sent it. There's a lot of stuff that they don't cover. Yeah,
that's true. That's true. Yeah, they're asking him, I'm sure.
Poor guy. He's just going to badminton class. He didn't do anything.
I know. Well, it's like, you know, I guess this is the other side of don't judge a book by its cover, but I mean, he doesn't look like a bad guy, right?
So no, he doesn't look like someone that would have that much amount of drugs on him.
Yeah. Well, maybe he is the fall guy. Who knows? Hopefully he's not. Hopefully you did it. Yeah.
Hopefully you did it, pal. And you're going to jail for a long time.
Yeah, Sonny.
Anyone could have sent it from his address. That's true.
You're going to be somebody's badminton girlfriend.
Harfett says anyone could have sent it from his address. What's your address, Sean?
Nanya.
We'll see if I can get you in trouble.
All right, so next we've got, okay, so this one, it's a little sad, but you know what? People joke about dead babies and stuff all the time, and this kid's way older than that, so it's okay.
Beep. Oh, I missed the headline. Oh.
There we go. Okay, so this poor kid who is allergic to everything.
Oh, no.
Died. Yeah, right?
Aww.
I mean, you kind of feel bad for the kid who flicked the cheese on him, too, just fucking around. The kid says he didn't know. I don't know about that.
He knew. He knew.
I don't know about that.
I don't know, man. I think he knew.
Yeah. Of course he fucking, I mean.
Oh, that's so sad.
This kid's allergic to wheat, gluten, eggs, milk, tree nuts, and had asthma. I mean, he is a gazelle waiting to be taken down by life. I'm sorry that it happened. You would think that the world was
so
safe.
You're calling the other kid who flicked the cheese a lion, basically.
How much trouble can we get it with? Yeah, no, maybe. I don't know.
Oh, that's so sad.
Very sad. I mean, a very sweet young
man. I didn't know that you could be that allergic that topically, that if something's thrown on your body.
Well, there's a twist, and I forgot about it. And that's that his EpiPen was way out of date. Let's see. I forgot that was.
Is this in the U.S.? Thing. Is it like because the EpiPen is like $7,000 or whatever?
Let's scroll up real quick and see where it's from. In London, West London. And his EpiPen was kept in the welfare room, had expired July 2016, with one email sent to his mother in February 2017 to inform her.
Oh,
and no
my gosh.
No follow-up contact.
Could you imagine missing that one email?
And
figuring out that's the email that you needed to read to keep your son alive?
Yeah. Yikes.
Because you know you miss emails all the time, and then you do a search
It. And the court also heard EpiPens which belonged to other students were in the welfare room and had not been used.
Now there's a problem.
What the fuck is going on? Wow, yeah, that's definitely an oversight unfortunately. Yeah, the kid that did it, I read that part that he says he didn't know. Quote, I did not know, to be honest. It was immature behavior. After he flicked it, and then the boy says that he said to him, after that, he just spoke to me saying, I am allergic to cheese. I apologized and went to class. He told people that someone put cheese down my throat, and they're assuming he just meant down the side of my shirt. But so that's kind of a weird part of the story, but very sad. Could have been prevented, but yeah, still weird nonetheless. Lots of weird things about it. I mean, being so allergic to cheese that,
like, that's what I was thinking, is like, I never knew that that was,
holy shit.
Like that.
Well, that's why you can maybe believe the kid, because even if we're fucking around, oh, that kid, yeah, he's allergic to everything.
Yeah,
he's,
but
like, cheese is good. He's allergic to cheese. Oh, really? He even says, the kid says, yeah, I thought it would like result in like a rash or something.
Right.
I could get that. Kids are dicks. Really, to think that it's gonna fucking kill the kid? I mean, that's a lot to put on a fucking another 13-year-old. Like, you thought he was gonna die from throwing. Maybe you're a dick.
Yeah.
Maybe you're an asshole.
But you weren't. You weren't trying to kill him.
But right. Yeah. So, but still, I mean, that kid that did it. I mean, I assume he's got some guilt, for better or worse. So, anyways.
Harfat says he gets all of his emails. And he also said he's never heard of cheese before. Harfat, well, what are you doing, sir, over there,
you're
tonight?
You're not living, Harfat. I don't know. In Mordor.
You need to eat more
there.
Cheese.
Shit. All right, so.
Not mortar?
You know what, John?
What? You know I'm.
The X for that, sir.
Do you know what?
That's not cool. I don't appreciate that. Anyway. where am I here? Oh, there we go. Okay, so lastly, we're on alligator. A woman has an alligator in her pants.
Is she happy
Start
to see you?
Your jokes now. Start building your jokes
is
now.
Is she happy to see you?
And we'll bring this over. Florida.
Oh, Harfat. He said not heard of heat cheese allergies before. You can't put that in the second line, and I read the first line and look like an idiot.
Hey, Tony. You join by checking out that number down at the bottom of the screen and pumping it into Zoom. 599-401-010.
You go to zoom.us.
Right. Zoom.us. Thank you.
And put in the number.
Yeah. All right, so we're going to switch here. Alligator crotch. All right, you should be able to hear me here. We'll see how interesting this video is after the... Okay. Yeah. I was wondering if that's real, but it probably is. Who knows? Doesn't say what day. This is from May 6th, so I think this was old. I don't have anything to do with what we were watching, but it's weird. It's 3.5 minutes long. Oh, maybe it's like a whole bunch of... Okay. Anyways, I don't think that video has anything to do with the... story. Just a 3.5 minute long fucking video. Fox News, fuck yourself. How about that? How about that, Fox?
Oh, lucky. My goodness.
All right, so pulled over and 3:30 in the morning. Naturally, she's got a little mini alligator in her pants. So let's figure out what the fuck this lady was doing.
So
22. She... Way too young to have an
was
alligator.
Too, was this on live PD? She claims
is that
they
a
were
joke
trying.
Or a serious question.
I don't know. Yes. Both? Both?
That's fair. That's fair.
Claims they were trying to collect wildlife from underneath an overpass. Investigators said the woman also had 41 small turtles inside of a backpack.
31. Yeah. I wonder about that. I don't know if I covered it on Weird News, but there was one of a guy trying to steal like a small shark that you would pet, like in one of those shallow petting pools,
mm-hmm.
by putting it in a stroller and walking out. But they like caught up to him as he was leaving the aquarium. So, yeah, people do. I don't know what the fuck. I guess the black market trying to sell it, you know, I assume. The state is often known for reports of weird crimes. Last week, sheriffs caught a fugitive who thought he could evade capture by wearing a hideous blonde wig. Yeah, I don't give a shit. God, Fox News blows ass.
Oh,
like, I give, why, they're
like we didn't ending, know that.
They're fucking ending the story with a paragraph about another fucking story and a link in it. That's, I mean, I didn't
the
learn
The state
that.
Is often known for reports of weird crimes. Just last week, the Brevard County Sheriff's Office caught a fugitive man who thought could have made capture by
that's like how...
You don't like
weird,
their clickbait stuff?
A strip. No, that's ridiculous. That's that. While it's not real journalism, obviously, this is clickbait. And I here we are. All right. I'm done with Fox News. Let's see here.
Should have never been included.
Should have never been included. I know.
The minute you saw it was from Fox News, you knew that it was going to be a clusterfuck.
Well,
you know better, Sean. You know better. Who cares about a girl carrying around an alligator and a bunch of turtles? People, I mean, I was downtown Cleveland the other day, and there was two ladies on dueling corners feeding birds.
What?
Yeah. Downtown Cleveland, public square, dueling corners.
Okay.
Like,
so they were trying to attract their,
yes.
their birds to them with the
yes.
food. I get you. Okay.
I'm like, wow, little old ladies still feed birds with bread they got from a hot dog stand. That's really cool.
Yeah. Well, crazy ladies. I've got crazy people that feed birds still.
One of them, yeah, was definitely crazy. Like, she was actually talking to the hot dog station lady because she was at, and it was interesting. I got this in just 40 seconds of crossing the block and the street. She was very excited because she got the big birds to stay away from the little birds by just piecemealing them different portions of different sized portions of bread. So then the big birds were going after the big chunks and the little birds were... And she was bragging about that to the lady selling hot dogs on the corner. And then the other lady, she crossed the street.
I'm sure she was enthralled.
And I'm looking like, over, right? I'm looking at this lady, like, feeding her birds and, like, having a conversation with the hot dog lady. And you see this other lady with just this huge smile on her face goes to the other corner and just pulls out this plastic sack full of just looks like crumbly old bread. And I'm like, not only are there's one... crazy old bird bread lady. I'm like, now we got bird brain too over here. And she was singing to him and like, it was delightful. Yeah. Hello, guys. I'm like, woo, this is awesome.
All right. So I'm back. I brought up the Floyd versus Zeppelin. If Tony wanted to come in and say his part. Until then, for a couple minutes, we can go and what I will do is share my screen again. Dun, dun, dun.
Harfett, you already, I read your comment that you put on the post. Oh, he was in here. Oh, he's not in video. That's okay. So you can either turn on your video or leave it off and then link up your mic. Can you hear us?
Yes, sir.
Hey, what's up, Tony?
Hey, how's it going, guys?
Good. How you doing?
Good, man. We're merging streams here, so I'm still alive, so I got you guys.
Oh, for sure.
Got you guys cool. here as well.
Now, you know you're coming in late, or did I tell you the wrong time?
No, I know I'm coming in late.
Okay. Yeah. No worries. That's cool. We're still going.
So were you the one that had the story about Led Zeppelin stealing music?
Yes. That is a real thing that happened.
Is it fact checked, verified? The world knows it, and I'm just late.
Yeah, there was
a
whole case
game?
About it. Okay. The opening riff to Stairway to Heaven was jacked from the band Spirit.
Unbelievable.
I can send you like audio proof of it.
Really? Yeah, that's almost, cool. I can probably do my research. I honestly had never heard that story before.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, there's like a whole court case for it.
Okay. Do you know if they won or lost the court case?
The song is called Spirit by the band. Wait. Is the song called Taurus? It's the song is called Taurus by the band Spirit. I don't know if you can you guys hear my computer audio?
Uh-uh.
Okay, I'll share this with you guys. Yeah, if you're interested in playing it, it's really crazy how uncanny it is.
Yeah, you can share your screen, Tony, here in Zoom, and there's a little checkbox that you check.
I just linked it in here.
Shares the audio. Oh, okay.
I'll grab it.
Grab it and play it. Harfat says very old news. Well, this is weird news, so.
Well, John needs to be filled in because he wasn't understanding.
I offended Sean on Twitter by letting him know that his take was complete bullshit. And so he's brought in Tony, and obviously you're on his side too, Harfat. So we get it.
Yeah, there it is. Little Yaz flute.
So what year is this?
Now this is, let's see, does it say the year?
It doesn't say the year. I wonder how long before, like, did they hear this song, like, playing
live? Oh, hey,
live?
Read that first comment. That sounds like something I would post.
So Zeppelin's, listen to the chord progression, though.
Oh.
That's... That's Stairway, dude. I don't care,
it's
man.
It's pretty fucking close.
It's like it's like when Mr. Baby Bitch 666 says you can't own a goddamn arpeggio or arpeggio.
I was gonna say it kind of changes up right there.
Right, it's like the whole, it's like that whole Vanilla Ice argument. It's like he's like, no, mine sounds like dun 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 dun. There's an extra note.
Or isn't it, who's the redhead guy that fucking was ripping off Marvin Gaye and shit?
Carrot Top?
Fucking Ed Sheeran. No?
No. It was
right?
A different guy.
Oh, really?
Yeah, he jacked, that he got actually sued for.
No, yeah, yeah.
Yeah, that was like a multi-million dollar lawsuit.
It's not Ed Sheeran?
No, it's, man, why could Robin Thicke?
Oh, him too, but Ed Sheeran. Yeah.
I don't know if I've heard of Ed Sheeran. I've never heard of Robin Thicke.
Yeah, so Ed Sheeran ripped off Marvin Gaye. And he faced a lawsuit over it for Let's Get It On. And so that's what I was thinking of. Yeah. So, you know, it's out there. It happens. People take inspiration.
So just by this piece of news alone makes Pink Floyd better? Is that like this is what's answering the age-old question of who's better?
No, John, it's that and the things I said, you know, that he's not singing about fairies. They're talking about real shit. Yeah. They've got a movie.
Yeah.
You know?
It's like woke shit too.
Yes.
Brainwashed in school and like
Led Zeppelin wanted to give people a release. You guys want to just tense them up and make them scared and angry.
No, man, you just dropped. We did the mushrooms story already. So, yeah. I mean, we combine all these stories together. Stay off of, don't eat marmot because it causes the plague. They carry the plague. Herpes be fucking. So, you know, use a condom. You know, these are just basic, you know, things that.
And if you're tired and have insomnia, smoke weed and listen to Pink Floyd.
Fucking A. There we go. That's how you live life,
man. Or do mushrooms and listen to Dark Side of the Moon.
There you go. Well, I've done on the third roar of the lion, you sync it up with, you know.
Yep,
Oh, you don't have to do that on YouTube, but yeah.
What's the movie?
Dark Side,
Wizard of Oz.
Yeah.
And it's crazy, like, you know, I always wondered, like, did they watch, was that a pure coincidence, which is pretty fucking insane if that's a coincidence, because it comes down to, like, the last scene where she puts her head on the Tin Man's heart and it's beating, and it's the heartbeat of the end of Dark Side of the Moon.
Yeah.
It's like that right there is like, come on, like, how did they honestly plan that out?
Money starts right as the color scene starts. Boom, boom. Yeah,
it's incredible.
Honestly, I hate that movie. So that's the only way that I would watch that movie Harfat says they opened up for Led Zeppelin, I think, or something like that. That band that we played, and he said, once you're on mushrooms, then Pink Floyd is it.
Yeah.
Frank Bacon says I'm a great plagiarizer. Great.
All right, so I guess it's settled then, John.
Yeah, I mean, yeah, for sure. You guys won.
Well, yeah. I mean,
we were saying, Tony, that, you know, Zeppelin has its place, right? You know, if it's summertime, you're feeling good.
Oh yeah.
Driving down the freeway, you know, fucking, you know, put on some Zeppelin. Yeah, man. That's fine.
Squeeze my lemon till the juice runs down my leg.
Yeah, I mean. Exactly.
What are you streaming right now, or what were you doing before you came in here?
I'm playing this game Mordow, which is I'm insanely addicted to it.
Okay.
It's like an indie game that was just released last week.
How do you spell it?
Mordhau. It's like they're calling it like Chivalry 3.0.
Is this the medieval one?
Cool.
Yeah.
Dude, my kid got it and he's like, play it. So I'm going to have to jump on.
It's nuts, man.
Yeah.
It reminds me of like the early days of online gaming where everything was like super toxic, you know, but like really competitive.
Like so many things.
Yeah.
Well, at the end of these weird news, Tony, we usually jump on and look at today's weird news because, you know, going up to this, I'm going through the week's news, finding the best ones, writing jokes and shit like that and reading about them. And then I don't get a chance to look at the ones from today. So we just kind of go through, and this is kind of our outro. So if anything looks like we want to fucking check it out.
Diver didn't understand what Seal wanted until it swam closer. Eternal lifestyle.
All right.
I feel like I'm on a game show.
Yeah. Well, we'll be good.
Points for that.
Life changing day.
If he just gives him a stupid fucking kiss, never forget then I'm going to be very disappointed. He better.
Why? Oh my God.
Because it's boring, John.
Kisses and love.
Yeah, I mean, everyone needs it.
Oh, it's clickbait. It's clickbait. It's clickbait bullshit.
How dare you, John? Strike one for you.
Oh, you know what? Sure. I didn't read that it was. Of course, I picked one of the sponsored headlines. Gosh darn it. I picked the ad.
Unbelievable. You're the mark, John.
You guys have finally found that out. I'm the reason why all these ads are on the side, because that's what I look at. Look at those shoes.
Unbelievable. All right, another sponsored. All right, we're doing this one. Let's see what this is. Brooklyn building collapses. Car crash building collapses in Brooklyn. Okay, come on. That's why.
What the fuck?
Oh, shit. It is fucked up, too. A car crash in a building that then collapsed into a pile of rubble. See, this is just fucking crumbling infrastructure. This isn't that. Except for whoever,
whoever put this website together knows about crumbling infrastructure.
It sounded like an explosion, and we just found out the out-of-control driver who slammed right into that Brooklyn building faces charges, including driving while intoxicated. They say it was a huge boom, then the roof caved in, the walls crashed down. I want to take a look.
Okay, no. Oh, wait, you got video?
Oh, here
no
where way. It happened. News 4's Wally Ellie.
No. I don't give a shit what this guy has to say. They're not going to show it. Okay, Doug Pitt reenacts his brother's scene from Seven. What's in the box? Dude, my kids Still don't know. God, does my older kid know? He might have seen Seven since then, but all their life, we'd be like, what's in the box? You can't watch the movie.
Photoshop this sure colorful accident.
Where are we?
Right above the Doug Pitt reacts. It says, Photoshop this colorful accident. All right above, right there. All right.
Let's see. Oh, shit.
Hey, that's cool.
Well, I want to know the... Is that like an industrial, like, print manufacturer? That's fucking crazy looking.
So is... There's no text, huh? It's just this picture?
No, it's just like, it's yeah, like here.
Here, right, take this.
Whatever.
Our pet said only one hurt with that building crash, that car crash.
Wow, okay, so yeah, Australia's got plenty of fucking... I mean, they're a continent of crazy people, of criminals, right?
They want to kick out their own indigenous people.
I know! Tony, what yeah, that's one of the stories, man. They're like wondering if the Constitution will allow for them to kick out the
indigenous aborigines, New Zealand,
the aboriginals. Wow. Yeah, like okay, well, I don't know how that's how it works. We think that'd be the same as sending the Native Americans to Mexico, even though we think Canada would probably be the ones to take them, right? So.
This is great. Man high on drugs accused of flooding South Bank Hotel. With 400,000 liters of water.
Shit. This is what the fuck did this guy do?
This is great.
How big of a shit did this guy have to take? Oh my god! Look at—is that him?
It's gotta be him.
He's like—he's like all so pooped out
to do on drugs.
Yeah, exactly.
He like, opened fire hydrants on every story.
That's some meth shit, man.
It says he opened fire hydrants on every story.
This guy went to work. Oh my god. Okay, I'm okay. Troll. We gotta see
the
this.
Whole fucking building's on fire, man.
People use Monday.com for all kinds of things. Like,
like Tuesdays. Awesome.
This is a long ad.
Oh, who we pimping right now?
No one.
Monday.com?
Friday.
Staff and hotel guests holy ran shit, for run, their bitch. Lives. Bradley Vogt was allegedly found Bradley. In a stairwell trying to mop up his mess.
What?
432,000 liters.
What do you mean he was trying to mop up his mess? What is that supposed to mean?
Oh God! This guy's oh, like, God. Oh God! I think I've done something bad.
After the third one, the fourth one, he's like, okay.
Water. After barricading himself
like
in an
office, water.
Oh, run, dude, run!
Control, Terrelgan man Jiu-jitsu. Is accused of lashing out at police.
Oh, this
and
is good
had
video.
To be sedated.
Oh, he's from the scene. They sedated
on May
27 okay.
last year, Vogt was a paying guest at the Bella Experience Hotel Apartments on City Road in
so
South
much
Bank.
Water.
But for reasons unknown, police allege he went rogue
half
and
half
opened
a million gallons of water
on level 1 to 18, flooding the entire building. As 300 people were evacuated.
So I'm not going home anytime soon.
No shit.
Firefighter Tim Erickson found the accused lying on the stairs, partially submerged in water and still holding his mop. He said, I had to do it. They are coming to get me. It's not safe. He begged me not
so
to
crazy.
Leave him.
Okay.
Police allege that Vogt
he begged me not to leave him.
Two
oh.
Ziploc bags of he methamphetamines. And that before the incident, he was doing drugs in his hotel room with a male associate. After everyone else had been evacuated, police found that man still inside the room and oblivious to the chaos his presence caused. The damage bill is still
oh,
being
shit.
But is estimated to be up to $1.6 million.
Oh.
9 News.
I hope.
She thought she was going to die right there. She was
People
like,
use
oh
Monday.com for all kinds of things.
Turn
like
off this
collaboration,
commercial.
Project management, production track, marketing planning, and more. Monday.com.
Well, that was interesting. That was a great
That was
one.
Awesome.
Shots fired at a Denver metro area school. Typical. No. Another day in America.
Can't do it.
Yeah, I'm not going to fucking click that. It's going to move yeah. shit down real quick, dude.
Bear spotted running down the street in New York. No word if it was going for Ty's bar. Oh, yeah.
That must be from a zoo in the middle of New York. That ain't no wild fucking... Holy
hey,
shit.
Run, motherfucker.
Bear.
I'm getting out of this, bitch. I hate New York.
Dude. my kid sneaks out of the house, man. He's just like, oh shit, I'm going to my girl's house.
He's like, any of you guys know how to get back to Tennessee? I gotta get the fuck out of here.
That's crazy. Bears are, blacks are more dangerous than grizzlies, they say. Or it's like, which ones will take you out? Let's see, I gotta click this one. When you think Baltimore is only, or when getting shot at is the thing you have to worry about. Oh, a super bug? Oh boy, here we go. A potentially fatal and antibiotic resistant fungal infection has been confirmed in 12 states, including Maryland.
Oh, yay. God.
Candida auris.
That's dope.
Holy shit, May 6th, so this is current. Nice. Three cases in Maryland. We got Cali, Connecticut, Florida, Indiana, Mass, Oklahoma, Texas, and Virginia. 600. Woo!
No Ohio.
So are we like losing fucking limbs?
No Washington.
No, yet. We got measles to worry about around here, John. Fuck.
Checkmate anti-vaxxers.
Are your, are your STD things having sex with themselves, though?
No. No. Well, I don't know. I mean, again, I'm not about that life anymore, John. I don't have to worry about it. All right. Well, this is boring now. Okay. This got really scientific at the end there. But yeah, so shit's going wrong there. It's always fucking typical. What else? Anything interesting here? Oh, see, now we're getting to the ones I saw today, some of them. Caption this family playing a board game. Okay, this is, oh shit, okay. What's this caption? This caption is, the board game for whites only. That's the first thing that comes up. We've got, sorry, you're not white. I mean, they're playing sorry, so sorry, you're not white.
Sorry.
I thought it was everyone, look, daddy doesn't know how to count.
Okay, all right. Sorry about the crack epidemic. Daddy's got to go to the moon.
That's a good one.
Yeah, yeah. I like sorry, no blacks. That's a pretty good one. As far as the racist one.
What's in the background, okay. Huh?
Can't see it. The records. For the old record player.
Yep.
And she's got the classic old hairdo. Yeah, okay. Yeah, I'm going sorry, no blacks. Sorry, no blacks allowed, even if you want to really spill it out. But let's see. Sorry, you kids don't have any. Sorry, you can't play with your black friends. That could be one. Okay, we'll stop. We're done. Let's see. City of Milwaukee won't pay for damage caused by potholes they failed to fix because they don't have money. Well, that sounds like
this is the same Milwaukee that spent over $120 million on a streetcar system and over $5 million on a new arena.
Yeah.
And will be hosting
fire
the DNC.
Every fucker in your city council.
And they're hosting a group, mayor. A huge group of liberals in 2020.
Yep.
Hmm.
Corrupt liberals. At that.
Number one takeaway from today's show. Germs evolve.
No shit, right? That has been the...
And so does this show.
Yeah. Yeah. Cabbie recognizes fare as rape suspect, drives him to the cops. Okay, we don't even need to click that. That's just the baller. He was like, fuck this guy.
It's kind of like the bus driver that stopped a passenger from getting sexually assaulted on his bus on live PD last week.
Dang, okay, there you go. Well.
Yeah.
Wow.
I guess the guy was like, you know, basically dropped his pants down and said, you're next.
Holy shit.
And the bus driver intervened and took care of it, subdued him and all that stuff.
Let's see. This is someone vandalized Gerald Ford. I just wanted to see what they did. I don't understand. What is this not it vandalized? I take it. They didn't know whose gravesite it was, they said. Doesn't say what they did.
You know, it doesn't surprise me at all that a 19-year-old wouldn't know the gravesite of a president from his state.
Dude, that is the story.
Way to go.
The story is that he's there fucking with the tombstone. Gerald Old Ford says right in his stupid fucking face.
Way to go, 19-year-old from Michigan.
Yeah. Okay, you're right. Way to represent your state. It's all that lead. You're welcome from your government. Boom. Next story. Let's go. Let's see. Oh, see, there's that alligator in the pants.
Cross-country cat accidentally goes to Florida. It's Fox News, though. Could be clickbait.
I hate cats. No one cares about cat stories, but we'll click it for you, John.
Yeah. Let's see. Pet cat accidentally hitches ride
from
Utah to Florida.
Better maul somebody on the way to Florida.
It's not going to be a good video.
I'm not clicking the damn video, that's for sure.
Driver passes DUI check, gets fined for having dog in lap.
Well, that's...
Click here. Oh!
Yeah, we see that around here.
Ooh, rare.
I'm going to click and it's going to be like a 5-minute story about poodles or some shit.
Aw. Sebastian.
Sebastian's gorgeous. Seems like he hitched a ride. Da, 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 da. Okay, yeah. Like he just jumped in the back of something.
That's kind of cool, though. How would he supposed to know where the truck was going?
Stupid cat.
All right. This has been
a blast.
Cat.
That cat's all fucking cross-eyed. That cat will shank you, man. Look at that cat. I didn't even notice, but I wouldn't trust that cat. That is a weird... I don't know if where he's looking. It's confusing. All right. Well, that's all. There we go. Boom. That's weird news there, Tony.
Cat story.
Tony, thanks for coming on, man.
No, we had to end. Oh, well, God damn it, John. You're right. We ended on a cat story. How dare you? You know what? But Pink Floyd's still better than Led Zeppelin, so it's okay.
See?
We have one new headline. Officials in Arizona want to combat the public health crisis that is A, childhood obesity, B, the opioid addiction, or C.
Ooh, we got to guess. Okay. Childhood obesity.
It's got to be porn. I mean, that's... Right.
I wanted to say porn, but I think it's A. I think it's A. It's ABC News. It's ABC News.
This couldn't be porn. Why would they put porn in it? Well, maybe that's just trying to be funny in the headline. We'll see here.
Let's do a new segment where you do porn, like porn link roulette.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, that's nice. Is it? They have
apples. Oh, there it is. You got it. You nailed it.
Arizona. Too many people whacking it in Arizona, huh?
What
or
is
did they look
the,
at?
They just spend too much time? What's the problem?
Yeah, why is this
a problem?
Yeah.
Oh, it perpetuates a sexually toxic environment that damages all areas of society. I get it.
It's a masturbation epidemic.
Potential detrimental effects on pornography include sexual behaviors, emotional, mental, medical illnesses, and difficulty forming and maintaining relationships.
Yeah. I mean, that's true. I mean, there's got to be something different about how you grow up when the first, like my first real discovery of porn I remember was working for this guy I lived on the same private road as, and he was like an old 80-year-old dude, and he had a stack of Playboys under his, and we would just steal one at a time over like 6 months. Because he had just so many of them, right? And then I got off the bus one day and I found like a hustler, like hardcore porn, and it was like wet. So like we had to like surgically remove the, you know, just like you could see through it, but you could see both sides. So it was like a double vatch thing going on. It was, and that was our porn. These kids don't know how easy they got it, you know?
I had the same situation, man. We had like a spot in the woods that we hung out in and just stashed it in a log. Like all this soggy porn in a lot.
I was gonna say, so
Tony's
where is it that it does
the forest a lot lately?
Where is this? Does it like, does it ever rain where you live?
Jesus. Tony's brought a new raincoat. Yeah, no, it did. Well, that's the thing. I hid it and I had it in a spot and everything, just like Tony. So I get like it's gotta be different growing up with it like right there all the time. The craziest shit you can imagine. Whereas, you know, I mean, there's got to be something different. And so I imagine I get that. But I mean, what the fuck are they going to do by deeming it a health crisis? Like, that's going to how somehow they're going to get money that they're going to like do bullshit with to try and combat it. I mean, I don't understand. This is a parental thing. You got to talk to your kids about sex and tell them that porn's not real. And that's like not necessarily how you meet and, you know, porn's court not, people. Yeah. And yeah, you know, this, I don't know. You can't expect other people and the government.
People don't just go around 69 in each other.
Well, exactly. But if you're a kid, you don't know any better. Next thing you know, you're falling off. You're, you know.
Yeah. You're trying to do pile drivers and throwing out your back.
Yeah, you know.
It is a public health. Now I'm convinced it's a public health crisis.
There we go. Exactly. So there we go. That was better. That's a little more up.
So the news. The headline is literally, there's a masturbation epidemic.
Essentially, it's a public health crisis.
No, because it's
more than masturbation.
It's how the excessive masturbation is affecting their health, messing with their minds. Yeah.
But I mean, just it's kind of funny that we're gonna fight this when there's like VR porn. It's like, come on.
It's an unwinnable battle. Yeah.
Exactly. You're not gonna fucking win, dude. I could be in the same room.
Porn is literally driving the VR industry too.
Pandora's box is open. Yeah.
Exactly. It's open. You're not going back. They've got sex brothels with just robots. I mean, you're not fucking controlling it, man. You got to embrace it.
Oh, boy. You're going to run on the embrace porn ticket, huh? Sean S. Porter 2020. 2024.
Hear ye. Yeah.
Sex, drugs, and rock and roll platform, baby.
More porn for you. I got DP.
All right, guys. Well, I got to get rolling. Who just joined?
Someone popping in late.
Frank.
Frankie, of course. How's it going? Hey, thanks, Tony.
Yep.
For the donos. I appreciate you jumping by, man.
Sorry for stepping in late, man.
That's all right.
I definitely want a full one of these, so.
Yeah.
All right, guys. I got to stop my stream. You guys can hang out. I'll leave the room open. But I got to go to the bathroom.
All right.
Hey, man. I'll be out, so.